Hello everybody, welcome to the third lecture in this series. In the previous two lectures, we have been introduced to the concept of critical thinking. We have seen the different aspects of critical thinking. We have even looked at one or two paradigms of critical thinking. In this lecture, we are going to continue looking at some more aspects of critical thinking. In the previous lecture, we had looked at Benjamin Bloom's critical thinking and Edward Glasser's concept of critical thinking. This lecture will be looking at some more aspects of critical thinking and the critical thinking we find in the paradigm of Bruce Williams. Now, look at this. We might have done everything. We might have done all kinds of critical thinking possible, but we might arrive at a wrong conclusion, and the result of jumping to wrong conclusions, a fracture is the least damage that can be caused sometimes. Very dangerous. It can have serious complications. Be careful. Be extremely careful about the conclusions we sometimes draw as a result of critical thinking. And also, be ready to critique yourself always, even after a conclusion is drawn. Aspects of critical thinking. We have seen till now that critical thinking is an important ingredient in almost all our activities, be it academic or non-academic. In this slide today, I would try to look at a few activities of critical thinking which are also not considered to be strictly academic. For example, a chef might use it to modify an existing menu or create a new dish. I think cooking involves one of the most acute critical thinkings that can be found around. A chef has to take care of the taste of the people, the nature of the available ingredients in a certain place, the cooking methods available to him or her, and finally, also, the most important factor is how best it can be served, how best it can be made likable to people. Sometimes critical thinking also might be used by a cricketer. In fact, the game of cricket, I think, uses critical thinking in a very intensive kind of a way. A cricket player might use it sometimes to judge an incoming ball or strategize a throw to mislead a batsman. And we find this all the time happening in the cricket field. A painter might sometimes do critical thinking while creating concepts on the canvas. We might have to take into account the kinds of colors that can be used. We might have to take into account the kind of concept that one wants to project onto a canvas and how best it can be shown. Those of you who have done a little painting will know that watercolor, the use of watercolors, involves a kind of logistics which is very different if you are using pastels or if you are using oil color. Similarly, the canvas on which you are painting also requires us to take up different combinations, work on them differently. And most important is the kind of concept you want to evoke on the canvas, the kind of mood you would like to extend, you would try to reflect on the canvas. All this again would need extreme amount of critical thinking, shaping the concept, gathering information, generating new kinds of insights, and finally transferring it onto the canvas, transferring your thoughts onto the canvas, transferring your emotions onto the canvas. A lot of critical thinking it involves. Finally, a scientist might use critical thinking to analyze the existing theories, propose new ways of looking at information, offer new solutions, etc. Now, of all these categories I have spoken about till now, I think it is the scientist's work which has been accepted, recognized, legitimized as critical thinking. But in this lecture, I would like to stress on the fact that critical thinking is used in many other fields legitimately as well. Imagine if you have done any cooking, converting a leftover curry of the previous day into something palatable, edible, likable. Lot of critical thinking is required. Managing a small crisis which has come up at home, knowing the people involved, finding out ways of dealing with the problem, coming up with solutions and making those solutions work for you in that particular context. Again, a lot of critical thinking is required. Do not underestimate the critical thinking that is put in by you, by the people around you on a day-to-day basis. Another important factor you must always remember while indulging, while involving in critical thinking is that different cultures use and value different kinds of critical thinking differently. Critical thinking is not a universal value existing out there in a vacuum. Critical thinking is appropriated, used by different cultures differently, depending on the socio-cultural background, the historical background a culture has, different kinds of thinking evolve, and what that culture considers critical thinking might differ. And when you are doing critical thinking, you will have to take that culture into account, you will have to respect the kind of critical thinking available in that culture and draw your conclusions accordingly. Now, I'll briefly talk about Bruce Willems' matrix of critical thinking. Matrix is basically a pattern, a paradigm within which critical thinking is done. I'll dwell a little bit on Bruce Willems' matrix because I find it a holistic, convenient, and a very user-friendly matrix which can help us do critical thinking, help us conduct critical thinking in various fields. He divides it in the following way. He talks about understanding or information as one area of critical thinking. Understanding of information, which involves comparing, contrasting, classifying and ranking, connecting and explaining, and analyzing. All these related to what was earlier talked about in Benjamin Bloom's paradigm as facts. What do you do with facts? You compare and you contrast facts, you classify facts, you connect facts with one another. You try to explain why they are connected in a certain way. You analyze why facts are the way they are. Why you are analyzing it, classifying it, categorizing it in a certain way. Very important aspect of critical thinking. The second aspect of critical thinking which Bruce Willems is talking about is generating insights. The important factor over here is evaluating or judging, visualizing or imaging, finding relationships, inferring, and making analogies. Making analogies is something which very crucial, very important to every kind of critical thinking. Making analogies was basically involve finding similarities, finding patterns, trying to see why a number of things happen together simultaneously at the same time in a similar way, and trying to understand what is the logic behind the formation of that kind of a pattern. Now, generating insights basically also involves evaluating, trying to see which kind of information is important in this situation, what kind of judgment is important in this kind of situation, and from the information available, one should also be able to image, visualize, create an image of it. Think, what can be done with this kind of information? How can it be categorized? What is the implication of categorizing something in a certain way? Infer meanings, infer categories, infer further meanings of it. Finally, the last category that can be talked about in this matrix is discerning implications. Discerning implications would mean finding implications in what you have earlier judged, evaluated, made analogies with. Now, part of discerning implications would be applying the kinds of analogies which you have already arrived at, applying the kinds of insights which you have already arrived at, create new modes of thinking, functioning, doing things differently, innovate, invent, generalize, sequence, predict, and transfer your findings, your insights from one paradigm to the other. Very important here is the concept of prediction. If you have understood an idea properly, if you have understood the facts properly, And if you have been able to categorize the facts in a proper way, in an appropriate way, if you have found the logic behind the facts which are present as such, you would also be able to predict effectively. See what next can happen. Given another set of facts, how will the behavior of things be? Will it be same? Will it be different? If same, why? If different, why? Very important part of critical thinking skills. Are you able to predict? If once you have arrived at one kind of conclusion, if once you have evaluated one set of information, will you be able to predict what would happen next? Would you be able to transfer this knowledge into another context? Would you be able to generalize it? Will you be able to sequence it differently? Will you be able to see what can happen in another situation, in a similar situation, etc.? Now, interesting. I was talking about the game of cricket a while ago. Let us now see what happens in a game of cricket. I'm sure many of you are interested. And I have tried to look at the game of cricket once a while. I've never played it though. And try to see what can be happening, what probably happens when a game of cricket is going on. If a team is constantly losing the game, the captain might go through the following stages of critical thinking. That is what I have tried to bring in this video. First of all, the captain might try to understand the information, compare and contrast the trend of failure and victory, sort the players in the winning and the losing games, analyze the order in which the players played. The captain would have to see which are the games they won, which are the games they have lost. Who are the people involved in the winning games? Who are the people involved in the losing games? See in what order the players played and try and find out if there was something common in all the games they won and in all the games they lost. After collecting this information, the captain might want to generate insights. Try and think which bowling or which batting order won. When. Analyze the kinds of turfs and infer if it had any impact on the performance. Connect which player played well in what condition. Here this also, one has to go beyond just the facts present. One has to also involve one's imagination. One has to focus on things which are not available and think, probably this player is doing well in this kind of a turf. Probably this game is doing better in this kind of a situation. Probably this kind of batting order is doing better and we are able to win more. Generate insights into the game. And finally, the captain would also have to discern implications. Find out what the implications are. If a particular order of players are doing well in a certain kind of a turf, in a certain kind of a situation, what are the implications of this? Can the same order be replicated in another situation? Or is the situation so different that you will have to drastically change this order? To do this, sometimes one might even have to take risks and say, okay, this does not look like logical, but probably this would be logical, this would be the logical step, and I will make this drastic change and probably this will work. Let me remind you, taking risk is a very important aspect of critical thinking. If you have to generate insights, if you have to predict something, there will be an element of risk involved in it, and you have to take it if you have to do some amount of critical thinking. Look at this here. What does it tell you? The poor bird, the small bird over here, had taken all the precautions, maybe made all the calculations, maybe made all the correct prediction also, that it will be able to take the food away and jump from that place into a safer place right on time. But what happens finally? It says, the risk I took was calculated. I did calculate the pros and cons properly, but man, I'm bad at math. I didn't realize that this bird would swoop in at this point in time so very aggressively and be there right in front of me like aggressive fate over there, which I cannot do anything about. So, no matter how much caution you take, There might be a problem. There might be a situation which you did not calculate. There will be a situation which you did not see in advance, which you did not imagine could happen. What happens at such a time? The best thing is use your EQ. EQ is a short form of emotional quotient. We believe these days that intelligence quotient is not enough. It is not enough to be intelligent only. It is not enough to be able to draw conclusions and know what is happening or draw inferences only. If there is a failure, if there is an unpredictability, if something has happened which you did not foresee would happen, how do you react in such a situation? That probably is what decides how you would be in future. Whether you are able to take the stress, whether you are able to take the risk, and whether you are able to take the responsibility of the consequence, positive or negative. So, in a situation like the small bird situation, the only thing that will help you is your EQ. And EQ is something you will need not only in this situation, but every situation which needs any amount of generalizing, predicting, looking at the future, taking a risk, etc. So, in this lecture today, we have looked at basically Bruce Williams' matrix of critical thinking skills, and I have briefly tried to, in a certain sense, summarize all the different aspects of critical thinking we have done before. This I have done specifically because these skills are rather fluid in nature. They come and they go. So one needs to go on talking about it again and again, repeat it sometimes, see how they can be used in different situations for it to settle down in your mind. Hope you enjoyed doing this lecture, listening to this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll be talking at a couple of one tool specifically, the tool of the mind map, which will help you a lot in doing critical thinking effectively. Thank you.